want to be singing.
Michael has had a profound impact.
He comes with a form of uniqueness.
No one's ever really done it like Michael.
Just had a finger on what would startle people.
Lewis has got such an original approach.
I think even to this day, nobody's gotten close.
It goes to show you that he's still hot.
Michael Jackson's number one hit, featuring Beyonce, Quincy Jones, Missy Elliott, Wyclef, and more. Including rarely seen performances by Michael Jackson and the exclusive world premiere of Michael's new song, One More Chance.
Ladies and gentlemen, please greet for their first visit, the Jackson Five.
My first impression of Michael when he was there on American Bandstand with the Jackson 5, way back in 69 or 70 or thereabouts, I went to interview him and he took the microphone with me, this little bitty guy, took the mic from me. I knew this was man in control.
Mike, can I have the mic back?
The first memory of Michael Jackson would be when he did the record Ben.
It's this romantic thing about a rat. I said, well, you're crazy, but he turned out to be right.
So beautiful. It had so many different meanings. It was so simple. It was about, you know, his pet.
You're always running here and there. You feel you're not wanted anywhere. If you
ever... Ben would be my favorite Michael Jackson song. A lot of people like Michael's fast records, and they're all great, but I like his ballads. I like the way his voice, you know, and he makes that little tremor in it and whatnot. I love that. And just the way he sang, Ben, and how it was smooth and whatnot was banging to me.
I used to say, now it's sad, now it's sweet.
That's one song I could never understand how anybody that young have that serious a song, and it'd be a smash.
But it's the choices that he makes when singing a song. He emotes. That's a gift.
I love the idea of Michael Jackson being young on the set of The Wiz in 1977 and meeting Quincy Jones.
I've never seen a young kid that aware and so observant and professional. I said, getting ready to move to Epic Records, could you help me find a producer? I said, I'd like to take a shot at it. He went back to Epic. Epic said, no way. Michael fought and said, that's who I want to use. I said, Michael, don't worry about it, man. I love to be underestimated. That's when I do my best work, you know. And we did our best work.
That drum lick is like one of a kind. Rock With You has to be my favorite song. He was singing a little more in his lower register, and he was sliding into the next note. Girl, close your eyes. And his vibrato was moving, and it just was sexy and just make want to rock with Michael.
The glitter suit he had on was beautiful on him. He was just beautiful.
I doubt we're going to see somebody come out and rock a whole sequin outfit. That's Michael, and it can only be done once. And we can ride the boogie, share that.
You just get under your ribs. That's that. Oh, God, why they don't make music like that anymore?
In this day and age, when a song is a good song, it comes and goes, and that's pretty much it. If it's a hit, it's got to be a major, major out-the-box hit to really get played 2 or 3 years later.
There's a lot of new records that's coming out that's more musical now. There's some Michael influence there because of the smoothness, the groove. That's what, you know, Michael and Quincy always had, that musical side of it, not just sampling a loop or you know, grabbing a hot beat. It was more musical.
Michael, from the time of his youth till now, has been the truth. What I mean by that, it was never fake, it was never phony, it was never a facade. It didn't take $1 million to make people notice how magical this man was. It's the kind of music that my grandmother could listen to and I could listen to at the same time and both be mesmerized.
Jackson, you listen to these songs are still fresh.